Yo, this is your favorite artist, D.P. Blah, blah, blah. Take. I just shot a Lion King themed wedding. Does it constitute as cosplay? I mean, they're not dressed as furries or anything, but check it out. Tell me what you think.
Bye. Take a moment to honor God. We want to pray for this newest addition to this family. Pray with me. Father, we thank you now for this life. We thank you now for this young man that you have already ordered his steps. Thank you for the grace that shall be upon him. I thank you that you've already planned to use his hands, his mouth, and his feet for your glory. We thank you now that no weapon formed against him shall ever prosper.
Yes, God. Yes.
And we thank you that your ministering angels shall stay with him for the rest of his life.
Yes.
And that you're going to write your story on his life. We bless his parents now. Give them the knowledge, the wisdom, the clarity, and understanding for the anointing that rests upon this young man. And every heart said in Jesus' name, amen. 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 Gentlemen, we are gathered. We're gathered together here in the presence of this company to rejoice, this man and this woman, on this occasion and to join them in the renewal of their marriage vows. They stand before us as an example of the blessedness, matrimony which St. Paul commended as honorable among men, and therefore do not by any to be entered into it unadvisably or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. So who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
Who?
We do.
But he took care of her.
He might as well, he had her for 20 years.
We do.
We do.
We do, thank you, sir. Lamar.
Yes, sir.
And Regina.
Yes, sir.
I can call you that right now.
Today.
Today. It's been a long time, long journey. Regina was only 14 years old. She ran into this young man walking with this great afro. His aunt lived next to her household. She had a chance out the window to see this afro in the driveway. And her window became the meeting place for years to come. Being 2 years older in high school, graduated, lost touch. But in 2003, got a chance to talk to Mommy. Mommy say, let me call Lamar. Lamar, do you want the digits? Yes, ma'am, I do. 6 months later, they were married. And today we stand here 20 years, celebrating 20 years of marriage. We describe you, as the Bible does, as Alpha and Omega. That is because you stand at the beginning, seeing the end at the same time. You, God, knew before anybody else did that we'd be standing here today. So we want to say thank you for the obvious grace and mercy and kindness and the noticeable love that you have shown on behalf of these two. What a journey they've had separately that brought them together. We want to thank you for that today. This is the day that you have made. God, we've made a decision to be glad in it and to rejoice in it. We ask that everything we do today brings you glory, yes. Brings you honor. Yes. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
At this point, the two of them have prepared their vows. Of course, after 20 years, they should know what they want to say one to the other and don't need me to tell them what to say. And so, if you would, sir, turn this way. Ma'am, if you would turn this way and just kind of look him in the eyes, we do want to start with Lamar, as you exchange your vows to her on this day.
Today, we begin the next chapter of this life that we've built together. And I can't think of anyone that I'd rather spend than with you. We started this chapter, we've been over some hills and through some valleys. Can't think of anybody I'd rather share it with than you. I thank God because he looked out when he was creating you and he had to have me in mind. My joy. Every day I wake up, even when I look out the window and the sky is gray, and I look in your eyes, it brightens my day. Your smile, sunshine pales in comparison. I don't know how long God has planned for me to live this life, but I do know that every second of every minute of every hour of every day of every month of every year that he has planned for me, I want to spend it with you. I thank him for every day that he blesses us to be together. We have been together. You promised me one day that even if we had to sleep outside on the ground on a cardboard box, you would be there with me as long as I was there with you. Life brought us almost to that point and you proved everything you said. You never left me. And I promise you this day that however long God has for me, this vow I give to you and I give to God, I'll spend every day with you. I'll love you. I'll take care of you. I'll honor you. You're my wife. You're my lover. And I think it's very safe to say you're my everything. Love you, girl.
My man.
Okay, so I was gonna write some stuff down so I wouldn't forget some stuff. And then I thought about it, and I did. We'll make it quick. First of all, let me say, these past 20 years has been an amazing, unique journey with you, sir. You understand me. I understand you. Some from the outside may look at us and think, oh, they're a perfect couple. But we're just the opposite of that. We're imperfect, but our imperfect works. We have a unique kind of love that only the two of us can understand. I spent my whole life explaining myself to people, explaining my intent, explaining my motives, trying to explain my heart. And I didn't have to do that for you. You know my intent. You know my motive. You know my heart. In 2003, God in his infinite wisdom decided to allow our paths to cross after 30 years. And I'm grateful. I used to pray that one day I would know what unconditional love felt like, what it looked like. And not just romantic love, but love, period. From friends, from family. You've shown me the scripture in living color that says a man should love his wife as Christ loves the church. When I would read that scripture, I would often wonder, what does that look like? How does Christ love the church enough to lay down his life for it? And that is who you are, Lamar. You have stood by me through the toughest of times. We have weathered many storms. And when I thought I was going to lose you in August of 2021 to COVID, I was beside myself with heartache, and I didn't want to let you know how fearful I was that you were going to die. And when the hospital called and told me to bring you back because they needed to put you on a vent, I refused. If you were going to die, you were going to die at home. I talked to God about it, and I didn't make any promises. I didn't say, God, if you heal him, I'll do this or that. I just reminded God that he gave me your heart, and God, please don't take it away. And so here we are today. You are the kindest soul I have ever met. I thank God for you being a father to all of our children. My family adores you, even to the point that I was threatened to be put out of this family.
Amen.
By that girl right there. If I ever left you.
Amen.
So they adore you. And your family adores me. Y'all do adore me, don't you? I thank you for your patience. I thank you for your love. I thank you for your commitment. I thank you for working so hard, not only to provide the things we need, but the things we want. You have given us a good life, and I thank you. You have taught me what a friend is. I stand here today, 20 years later. I pledge my heart, I pledge my loyalty, and I pledge my commitment again. I love you.
Wow. I do want to publicly say, on behalf of my family and my siblings, that I have watched you take care of my mother. And I want to say this, that not one day have I ever worried. Now, I used to worry about my mother. I mean, y'all can say what you will, but that's my mama. She got two other children, but you get what I'm saying. Yeah. But the day y'all got together, I never worried about my mother. You work harder than me.
Yeah.
And I'm younger than you. Thank you. And for me to get this opportunity to stand here before the two of you, me look you in your face and say that, it's an honor for me to be there. Thank you for taking care of her. And I know that you meant every word because I watched you. The patience you show her. And I'm so proud to say that every time my wife and I celebrate our anniversary, we know y'all coming right behind. That's amazing to me, yeah. Right? That really is amazing. So, okay, we got the rest of this thing to do. We're gonna have the exchange of rings at this point. So you guys gotta keep facing each other. I'm not sure I really need this, but I do need my hands, so. All right, Lamar, we're gonna start with you, sir. If you would just take her left hand, yeah. Yeah, grab that rock. My time for a rock. And so, just, yeah, yeah. Just ever so slightly put it on there and repeat after me. All
Right there. Don't go too far. Repeat after me. With the giving of this ring, I renew my vow of love and loyalty.
I renew my vow of love and loyalty.
With sincere affection. And with all my worldly goods. I continue to be endowed. In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Slide that on there. Yes, sir. All right, now let's get hers and let's flip that around. And please repeat after me, just halfway. With the giving of this ring, I renew my vow of love and devotion. With sincere affection. And with all my worldly goods. I continue to be thee endowed. In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
If you will, just join me with a quick word of prayer as we, just speak a blessing over these two. Yeah, you got a little green too. Keep your hand in your hand. Pray with me. Dear God, we thank you once again for what you've done in this couple's life, where many have not understood, you ordered the way. Thank you that our union with our spouse has nothing to do with anybody else but you. And I thank you for every victory that they've won. I thank you for every storm that they've weathered. And Lord God, I thank you that they are an example of biblical love, something to look up to and to look forward to a generation that badly needs good examples. Thank you that they are a light in a dark land. Today we pronounce a blessing upon them. We speak life, abundance, health, and wealth. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Well, Regina, that sounds good, wanted us to read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, but we've affectionately called that the love pact. So we're going to do that love pact thing here. Now y'all can face each other once again. And I just need you to repeat after me as you, I keep holding that hand and repeat after me, Lamar. I am patient with you. Because I love you. I will treat you kindly. And never be jealous. I will not allow. Boastfulness.
Or pride.
To interfere with our love. Oh, Lord, that'll preach right there. It's your go. Here, ready, Regina?
Yes, sir.
I will be considerate.
Towards you.
And seek to fulfill. Your interests.
Above my own.
I will avoid.
Being angry.
I will avoid.
Being angry.
Oh, I read that twice. With you. And keep no record of wrong. Somebody say amen. Lamar. I will take no pleasure. In anything that hurts you. But rejoice. When you are honored. And acknowledged.
I will protect you.
Trust you. And hope the best for you. Yes, Lord. Gina. My love for you. Will preserve.
And persevere.
And with God's help.
It will never fail.
Amen. Ain't that something?
Yes.
I tell you. Well, it is my pleasure, my honor, my pleasure and honor. Lamar Hodges and Regina Hodges. Yeah. They have considered together in the renewal of their marriage vows, have witnessed the same before God in this company, thereto have pledged their faith each to the other by giving and receiving rings and exchanging vows and joining hands. I now pray God's richest blessings and richest benediction upon them. Ah, yeah, for the rest of their days, husband and wife together, in the name of the Father, name of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Sir, you may kiss your bride again.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you, once again, 20 years later, Mr. and Mrs. Lamar Hodges.
Steady love. so natural to make a light. Cause he's a perfect compliment. Cause I'm a boss in my world. But when we're together, he just makes me feel like his girl. He's giving me love so steady. He touches my heart. Now I'm ready. He touches my soul and my spirit. He's giving me love so steady. Sleep near him, walk with him, be with him
every day.
I wanna be lovers and friends and mother his children. Make breakfast on Sunday and fight and then make up again. Cause if life's gonna be crazy anyway, I wanna do it with him.
Steady love.
Hey.
Ooh. Steady love.
He's a good father, he's a good cook. He loves his basketball, and he loves a good book. I'll tell you how I know he's the perfect one for me. Cause he's a warrior in the streets, but he's a king in the sheets. He's giving me love
so steady.
He touches my heart, now I'm ready. He touches my soul
and my spirit.
He's giving me love
so steady.
He's giving me love
so steady.
Children.
I'm kidding. I'm a vegetarian.
That's what I'm talking about.
You want me to do one for the couple?
Yeah.
Lamar, Queenie, I could not be happier for the two of you. Continue to love and respect each other as we continue to love and respect you. Congratulations on your special day. Mbaku.
Nice. We'll be right back.